Today we're doing the newest Hero WOD by CrossFit. It's Holleyman. It is 30 rounds, 5 wall ball, 3 handstand push-ups, and 1 power clean. The wall ball is to a 10-foot target with 20 pounds, and the power clean's at 225. I'm Shaun Eagen, and I have been CrossFitting for about 3.5 years now. This was my 3rd year competing. I made it to regionals in 2010, 11, and 12, and I took 6th place at regionals this last year. Approaching a workout like this is a long workout. There's 30 rounds, it's heavy. And it's a Hero WOD, so Hero WOD always means a lot to most of us that do CrossFit. It's to someone that has fallen, and I always like to approach it with that give it everything I have, because I know they did at some point. Fairly simple movement, but 5 at a time isn't really a big number, but it adds up to 150. 30 rounds is a long time. So looking at this, first thing we want to focus on is body position. That we don't want to be tipping through the front of this. We want to keep it nice up at the chin. We don't want it to drop down to our waist or anything lower. And keeping the elbows in and the chin neutral. A lot of times I'll see, as we go through that wall ball, you tend to start staring at that target, and we're getting into a position something like so as we squat down, and that's putting a lot of stress on the shoulders. With the handstand push-up, we want the shoulders to be as fresh as possible so we can do the handstand push-ups efficiently and still continue to do the wall ball efficiently. Of course, we can scale the weight, scale the height, but give yourself a target that you try to hit every time. Handstand push-ups being in this workout. The goal is, of course, hopefully a strict handstand push-up to make this as fast as possible. For me, I'm a fairly big guy. I tip the scale about 225, so kipping is gonna come into this pretty quick. But going through this, trying to get that hard kip up every time, and I wanna find a good position at the bottom. I don't wanna fall off the wall. So as I'm coming down, I'm really gonna focus on my tripod position, that my hands are actually out in front of my face as I come down, so I don't line up, and I use my shoulder a little bit, shoulder to tricep a little more properly. Easy ways to scale this will be to kip it. We can use the box and get into that upside L position, or using the rubber bands like off a pull-up bar to get you into that full handstand position. I teach the kip a little bit differently possibly than most will, especially with the handstand. I actually have people lay down, and we get on the platform so they can slide. So it's done something like so, that will be up close to a wall, and we have a good setup here that we'd be up close to the wall, we'd bring our legs up, we'd then shoot our legs down and press all at once, and when we get that kick and press, we're able to slide and kind of understand that timing a little bit more. I'm gonna stick with the power clean every time as prescribed. Going through this, my big focus is gonna be the jump. Once I get it over the knee, that big jump, shrug, and pull to make sure that I don't have to drop down too far. I don't wanna burn out my legs. 150 wall ball total is in this workout, so I'm trying to use as much through that power as possible. First obvious easy scale is weight. 225 is a lot. Let's work that down, maybe something 185, but give yourself a benchmark, a goal. For me personally, this is like 70% of my 1 rep max power clean. So maybe give you a little perspective. I got to round 15 and I was like, man, it's halfway done. And then I got to round 20 and that's when I felt like I could kind of gear up again.
Okay.
Those last 10 rounds, I don't know how my pace was, but I felt like I was a little bit smoother. It felt like 12 through like 20 was a little rough, and then I felt kind of rejuvenated once I hit that final third of that workout.